It's one of those lovely crisp frosty mornings up here. The workshop in the forest. Frost just going, so have a quick coffee and we'll get on with the Land Rover stuff. Looking at the front half shafts today. Nearly having gone right the way through the race, it's begun to split where the oil's come through. So the thing to do now is to take hammer and cold chisel, just open it up a bit. So as you can see, it's now removed without any damage to the half shaft whatsoever. What happens is the collar heats up as you're grinding through it. Just as you start to get through, you stop, and as it cools, it cracks. So it's as easy as that. So you just split that with the chisel again. It's left the shaft undamaged. Take that off, clean it up as well, I think. The other half shaft's done. I've already changed the UJ on that one, so I just wrapped it up and cable tied some cloth around it to keep it clean. I'm ready to put the new races on this one. I've got the bearing race to go on first. It's going to need heating. Likewise the collar that the seal runs on. Now hopefully they'll just drop on. If not, I've got a bit of pole to persuade them with. My gas torch is a bit lackluster, but it should do the job. Just take a few moments, that's all. Probably slightly blocked yet. Turn the I don't know what this sort of spacer thing is, but that's right home now. Too cold. Alright, well we'll have a go, see if we can press that on there. 3 tabs. I found some 20mm plate steel, so not quite as bendy as those little shims. Didn't think it'd take quite as much force. Like the health and safety there. A few tons, not too bad. I'll just give that a clean up, make sure there's no burrs on it, and that one's done. Although we've got to put the new universal joint in, but apart from that, it's there. Looks okay to me. I spent a bit more time heating the collar on this side and it fitted nicely. Just drop straight on. What I did this time, which is something I should have thought to do first time round, is use the screwdriver, thin screwdriver, to scoop up this piece as I heated it and transfer it over to the half shaft. That way I didn't actually wick too much heat from it by picking it up with the gloves on. Drop straight on, so very pleased with that. Tested to see if that rotates. If not, you know, everything's fully seated where it should be. So this one is done. As you can see, it's got a nice new GK in off shaft bearing, universal joint rather. So we'll put the other together, get the new UJ in that now. So you see what I'm doing is trying to use the yoke of the universal joint to actually keep the rollers in the caps. Now normally if this was a prop shaft UJ, I would say grease the circlips before you put them in, but this is all going to be running in oil anyway. There we are, it's taken a few hours, but the bearing races and seal colour have been changed on each, as have the UJs. So they're ready to go back now. The spline ends, of course, you want to check. They've got very minor wear, but they're not bad at all. What you're looking for is to see that the end isn't twisted. Something you might typically find on a vehicle that's been heavily off-roaded. If wheel spin is induced and the front wheel then grips suddenly, it can cause these to twist eventually. So yeah, these are in good nick. We're back home now and I've just put this half shaft in its relevant housing. As you can see, changing the bearings was a good move. There's no play in that bearing, it's perfect. Obviously the yoke of the universal joint is against the housing, but basically I was looking to see that there was minimal play there. Really good. Just go around the other side. So I'm glad I decided to do that in the end. Realistically, the half shaft doesn't sit quite that far in, it's about half an inch further out, so the stub axle seal runs on that land there. Yeah, should be right, I think.